LSU Grand Prix of Figure Skating final continues. The men's short program is still to come with late news that Canada's brightest prospect in this event, young Jeffrey Buttle, has just withdrawn, still suffering the ill effects of food poisoning he developed when he arrived here at midweek in Colorado. How disappointing is that, Barb?
Well, it has to be absolutely devastating. You know, he's had such a great season this year. Of all the skaters, I would say he's benefited the most from the new scoring system. He's won one event and placed second at another, only to the world champion of Evgeny Plyschenko. This event really could have solidified him as one of the top-ranked skaters in the world today going into the World Championships.
So, Paul, that leaves Canada's chances with Emmanuel Sandu, who himself was a late substitute here for American Tim Gable, who had to withdraw because of skate problems.
Well, this provides Emmanuel with a bonus opportunity to show the world that he really can skate with the very best men in the world. He has the talent. We've seen moments of utter brilliance, but the consistency in delivering that brilliance is not there yet. This is his chance to show everybody that he belongs.
We'll see Emmanuel Sandu and the men later in the program, but up next it's the dance. And how wide open is this competition now under this new scoring format?
Well, I think of all the skaters, the ice dancers have got to be the most ecstatic. They've seen more movement in the 6 Grand Prix events this year than I think we've ever seen in the history of ice dance, and it gives them all hope, faith, and belief that if they skate well, they'll get rewarded and place well.
So here are the top 6 ranked teams from the Grand Prix season skating in the opposite order that they finish. The Canadians, Dubray and Lauzon, will skate second. The Russians, though, have to be favored with the retirement of the world champs Shailene Bourne and Victor Kratz.
Well, Mehdi France and Patrice have had an excellent season to this point. They started at Skate Canada, showed up with the most technically difficult programs, were rewarded for those, and that sent a message out to the entire dance community that if you want to score well under this system, you'd best come prepared with very highly demanding programs.
This is a team that's ranked number 1 in the world right now with the retirement of the top 2 teams in the world. They're well known for their great speed and their originality, but they were beat earlier in the season by the Russians, Navka and Kostomarov.
And although the Bulgarians may be ranked number 1, this team, Tatiana Navka and Roman Kostomarov, I think are getting the nod. They won all 3 of their Grand Prix events this year so far. They've got speed, they've got flow, they've got style, they've got everything that you'd like to see in a top-ranked world-class dance team.
This is how the ice dance is scored under the new code of points. It is now more a test of skating skill rather than a popularity contest.
Well, they're now, like the single skaters, this original dance has got some prescribed components that must be done, that have a tangible aspect to them, and this is something so, so radically different to the world of ice dance.
Here are Isabelle Delabelle and Olivier Schoenfelder. Olivier's skates didn't arrive until the night before this competition, so he's had no chance to practice at this elevation.
Prescribed rhythm this year is the swing combo. The skaters need to perform 2 or 3 of the following: the swing, jive, boogie woogie, jitterbug, rock and roll, or the blues. Very audience friendly. Lots of fun to watch.
Olivier's skates got lost in transit in the post 9/11 travel rules. Skates can no longer be checked on board. They have to go with the baggage, and they didn't come with him.
Here's their midline step sequence. They do this very well. This is like the quad in men's single skating. This is where you're going to see mistakes happen. Great unison.
Oh, yeah. Now you can call me paranoid, but I somehow I did avoid defying logic, faith and law, and the only way to get it.
Sign of a good dance team is a team that has the ability to change atmosphere, mood with the change in their music. I think this team is doing a decent job of that. Their diagonal step sequence, the second of two required step sequences in the original dance.
Isabelle Delabelle and Olivier Schoenfelder.
I thought that was a very well-skated dance. It had great energy. I thought the footwork sequences were very strong. Here's a look at their midline step.
Judges, of course, are looking for unison, how close they stay together. Does the step have turns and rotations in both directions? And Barb, you mentioned how well a performance they've skated. I think it's a great performance. Had I been him, having to stand around here for the two or three days leading up to this performance with not knowing where my skates are, when they're going to get here, they've done great.
Well, their original dance at Skate America was the best this year. They slipped to third overall.
The technical score for this performance.
As we await their marks here in Colorado Springs, 17.70 for technical elements, 36.44 in program components for a total of 54.14.
The total segment score for the original dance is 54.
So that's the benchmark. First skaters complete. Delabelle and Schoenfelder of France. Now the Canadians, Marie-France Dubray and Patrice Lausanne from Montreal, but now training in Lyon, France. They come in with a world ranking of 8th. Marie-France and Patrice, sorry Barb, have been together for 7 years now, and this Grand Prix final, 3 times in a row they finished 6th. They're trying to get out of that rut.
Well, it's quite an accomplishment to have actually made it to the Grand Prix final. That in itself allows you to put a feather in your cap.
Come on, baby.
Like a rootin' tootin' Texas cowboy, but this Lone Ranger's never seen a horse. We wanna be an Americano, Americano.
They're gonna open
Americano
with the midline step as well. A little bit slow. It's not carrying a lot of speed across the ice. Good unison though.
It's always the dilemma to sacrifice speed for difficulty, and that's where you've got to come up with the best combination for you.
They always have very high difficulty though on their lifts. And extremely effective.
Mary Frost and Patrice were third this year at Skate Canada, second at Lalique. Marie-France Dubray and Patrice Lauzon of Canada in their original dance in Colorado.
Well, certainly a performance full of energy, full of excitement. You can't accuse this team of not trying to come out and put on an entertaining skate. Watch through this segment, all of your lifts, as you mentioned, Barb. Fast moving, cover a lot of ice, high degree of difficulty.
And now the wait for these new numbers.
For Marie-France Dubray and Patrice.
Well, most of these competitors, of course, will have benchmark scores because they've done two or three competitions. They know how their programs have been scored previously, and I'm sure they've all got those numbers committed to memory.
The total program component.
And their technical score, 18.20, higher than the French team, but the program components are down, 35.71, so the total score of 53.91, not enough to overtake Delabelle and Schoenfelder. And the disappointment is clear for the Canadians. The favored Russians, Navka and Kostomarov, putting on their game face. They're still to come.
Of the Broadmoor Hotel in Colorado Springs, this pond is right where the old arena used to be, where they held five world championship. Our next competitors in the original dance, Elena Grishina and Ruslan Goncharov of Ukraine.
Brilliant start to their season last year, winning three Grand Prix gold medals, their first golds ever. This year, three silvers, Skate America, Cup of China, and NHK. Both met when they were 12 and 14 years of age and were married in 1995. Some veterans.
They were caught off guard earlier this season at their first competition, where they discovered much of their program was not difficult. It wasn't up to the standard of many of the other skaters, so they have really taken the steps over the course of the season to upgrade their difficulty.
This high-energy opening section has gone very well for this couple, but what's impressed me the most has been the sureness of their transitions. Every time they break hold, they go to grab hands again, they're right there, hand in hand, immediately.
Ago in practice and really wrenched her knee.
Midline step sequence.
This angle gives you an excellent opportunity to see how close they stay together. She had a little trouble there on her twizzle, broke the unison, and they've also gotten a little further apart. The goal is to stay as close together and in perfect unison as they can possibly be.
Grishina and Ruslan Goncharov of Ukraine
I thought that was a very, very well performed dance. They had a great deal of difficulty in the footwork sequences. As you can see here in the side by side, she gets a little bit off at one point there in the sequence, but overall I thought the performance was great. Program component score should be very high.
I like the fact that even though this style of dance is a quick, hectic, it's almost jerky type motion, they still have the opportunity to give you some line along the way, and that's critical to the eye.
The technical score.
Well, they upgraded their program throughout the course of this Grand Prix season, and they're being rewarded here today. Technical elements 18.80, program components 39.44. The overall score to beat is 54.14 from the French. And so Grushina and Goncharov, with 58.24 points, will move into first place.
And the current ranking for Yelena Grushina and Ruslan Goncharov.
So a good beginning for the Ukrainians here in Colorado Springs. And now the top-ranked team in the world in ice dance from Bulgaria. Albina Denkova and Maxim Stavisky. Bronze medalists at the World Championships this year. They won a silver at the Europeans. Those are the first medals ever awarded for Bulgarian skaters in an ISU event. It's their best season ever.
This is a man's world. This is a man's world. But it wouldn't be nothing. Woman or a girl. You see, man made the car to take us over the road. Man made the train.
Quite like the transition into that pear spin and out of it.
Here into their midline step sequence. Much of that performed on one foot, which gives it a higher degree of difficulty.
Albina Denkova and Maxim Stavisky of Bulgaria, World Championship bronze medalists. They narrowly defeated the Russians, Navka and Kostomarov, for that bronze. They're still to come.
Many regard Maxim as one of the finest male ice dancers in the world. When they skate together, he is so smooth skating with her that you hardly even notice the degree of difficulty that he's doing during the course of the performance. Smooth, the operative word for this team.
Well, the Bulgarians finished third in the Grand Prix final last year, and they put pressure on themselves to move one or two steps better. And here are their scores. 18.20 in technical elements, 40.06 for components.
That's a huge second mark.
And 58.26 overall. That is just 0.02 of a point better than the Ukrainians to move into first place. First place by 0.02 of a point.
Maxim Stavisky from Bulgaria is first.
So the Bulgarians have set the standard here in Colorado. As we remind you that coming up tonight on Hockey Night in Canada, Alexei Yashin and the New York Islanders visit Toronto to play the Leafs. It all begins with Saturday night, 6:30 Eastern, with Ron McLean.
From the United States.
Now, the Americans, Tanith Belbin and Benjamin Augusto. Tanith is actually a Canadian from Kingston. Ben from Chicago. They both moved to train together in Canton, Michigan under Igor Spilband. And they've made some enormous progress in 4 years together, moving from 13th to 7th in the world 1 year ago.
Well, the amazing thing about this team is that they feel very strongly that she will not gain her United States citizenship in time for the next Olympic Games in Turin. So they're looking at Vancouver 2010 as their long-term goal.
That is long-term.
Interpretation is such a key factor in ice dance. I feel this team, in this particular dance, their whole body has truly captured the essence of the music that they've selected.
Not just putting on a show here. You really get the feeling when you watch them skate that they are really loving what they're doing so much, and that's why this team has become so popular.
They're still so young. Tanith, 19. Benjamin, 21. World Junior champions just a year ago.
Some other man do. Why don't you do right like some other man?
By going to that 1 foot in that lift, it automatically raises the degree of difficulty for the dance lift to a level 3, which is the highest level of difficulty.
Spin is also a level 3. Good changes of position. Wow.
Oh, 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 a little bobble there by Benny. Got really close to Tanith there.
That's why those steps are the triple axel of ice dance.
Oh, a big ovation here in Colorado for the Americans, the new kids on the block, Tanith Belbin and Benjamin Augusto. Terrific original dance program.
Well, they've certainly made the transition from the junior scene to this senior level competition very well in a very short period of time. To actually be here at the Grand Prix final is an amazing accomplishment.
This footwork very difficult, but Ben gets off balance there, and that's going to hurt them on when the judges go to grade the execution of this element.
Paul, you talked about their amazing progress. Just 2 years ago, they were winning the junior Grand Prix final, and here they are, a real threat in this Grand Prix final championship in Colorado. The score to beat is 58.26 2-6, and they've done it. Wow, 59.81, their total score in this original dance. So this young team, training just outside Detroit, continues to get better by the week.
I think the most important thing to see there is that their technical elements have been the highest so far in this competition. And these dancers are becoming very aware of how important it is to keep every element in your program at the highest possible level.
Well, Ben's had them on an ice boot camp this year for 3 weeks, and it's paying off in their fitness. Now the Russians, Tatiana Navka and Roman Kostomarov. Ranked number 2 in the world, but clearly considered the favorites here. First in all 3 of their Grand Prix events this season, Skate Canada, Cup of China, Cup of Russia. They were runners-up last year, hoping to go for gold this time.
No sunshine when she's gone. It's not warm when she's away. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. And she's always gone too long.
This team is well known for wonderful long lines and beautiful highlights, but they've really had to upgrade the difficulty in their steps.
Tatiana's stunning, and she's always been the better of the two skaters. She's really upgraded his skate.
And this house just ain't no home. Anytime she goes away.
Watch this step sequence. They perform a great deal of this step. The step's on one foot here, which makes it much more difficult.
You really have to use your edges to develop and maintain the flow when you stay on only one foot.
And that sequence has the highest degree of difficulty at a level 3.
Tatiana Navka and Roman Kostomarov of Russia. And a stirring original dance.
I thought they performed it extremely well. That combined with the fact that they had a high level of difficulty on most of the elements is really going to make this one difficult to beat.
Well, I felt the last two performances that we've seen have been very comparable in terms of the energy, in terms of the interpretation of the music. Technically, both solid programs. This is when the judges really earn their keep, because they have to make some critical decisions here as to why they like one over the other, because at the end of it all, we get a printout of it all in fine detail that tells us what they thought was better in one program over the other.
Oh, look at those numbers. The Americans had the lead score of 59.81, and the Russians have just blown them out of the water. 65.18 points and the lead. Navka and Kostomarov have a huge lead after the original dance. The Americans second, and the number one ranked dance team in the world, Denkova and Stavisky, currently sitting in third place after the short program. There's Canada's Emmanuel Sandu, a late addition to the field.